Hi everyone, welcome back to my interview series. My name is Meher, I'm from Vancouver, BC. For those of you joining me for the first time, welcome to my channel. The purpose of my videos is to give tips to job seekers by interviewing experts in the field. So if you are first time watching, please subscribe to the channel so that you'll get all the notifications when I'm posting the videos. So let's start with today's interview. Hi everyone, welcome back to another interview series with me. I'm very privileged to interview today Jeff Smith. He's a seasoned executive and the founder of the SupportingLines Institute. His mission is to inspire leaders and help the teams perform so that millions of people become engaged in their work. Welcome, Jeff. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. Thanks for having me.
Thank you for being with us. So tell us more about yourself and why you ended up creating the SupportingLines Institute.
Where to begin? Okay, I'll give you the short version of a much longer story. So I started this company in January. And so we've got at this point a number of coaches, I guess a few people helping me with the business. And what we're, as you mentioned, the purpose that you talked about for me is essentially that's the purpose of the company. We're trying to engage millions of people in their work. And I'll come back to that in a bit. I think for me, it was really, I'm at a stage in my career where I've been, C-suite executive, I've been a global sales VP in a $1 billion company. I've got other things in my background. You know, I'm a certified executive coach. I'm a certified yoga instructor. So there's a whole bunch of things that kind of come together that have really helped me understand how I can be a better leader, because that's definitely still a project that isn't finished, and also how I can help other people be a leader. So when I was at Mobify, I found that was really where there was a big focus on how I could help other people be a better leader. And so some of the things we did there was we created different tools people could use. We created some different processes and things people could use. And it was really, really working. So engagement went up. We were getting better at achieving goals. So all the programs we're putting in, they were really helpful for people. That was the feedback I was getting. And so I loved working at Mobify, and I've loved working at the other companies I was at. It just felt like it was time at this point in my career. You know, I had something to share with many people. Mm-hmm. I want to help coaches expand their practice, executive coaches, by giving them something that they have that's a clear offering. And collectively then, leaders, coaches, the companies we work with, yeah, what we're trying to do is help lift the engagement for millions of people, because 85% of the world's population is not engaged in their work. Mm-hmm. And I felt like I had something that I could bring to that.
Yeah. And any struggles while you were creating the Institute that you can share with us?
I think the biggest struggle in creating the Institute was it's kind of the ongoing one for the entrepreneur. It's like I need to balance my time between content creation, for the program itself. So we're constantly evolving the framework. I also need to be focused on business development. And at the same time, the thing that pays the bills is when I'm delivering, coaching, workshops, training, that sort of stuff. So trying to find the right balance between those three is really hard, because I enjoy all of them. I need to do all of them.
Yes.
And so it's just, how do I move the ball forward each week, but not overinvest in any one of these areas, at the expense of the others?
I totally agree with you. You're creating content, networking, engaging, and then we need to pay the bills, right? So we're all creating all this, and I feel you. I've been there, and I see you. I am there also in all creating all this that I'm giving back to the community. That's the main reason for the time being. And Jeff, thank you for sharing how your struggles, because I feel that that's all the struggles for other content creators or entrepreneurs. And for the audience watching, if you have other struggles that you feel that will be good to mention, and how are you coming those struggles, please leave it in the comment section. We'd like to hear from you, and tune in next time for another question with Jeff.